I think, first of all, they should receive a very, very clear message that quitting remains the best thing they can do for their health. But today, there are alternatives that do not burn tobacco, that generate significantly lower levels of harmful compounds and are a much better alternative. And possibly, they should be encouraged to switch, like it happens today in countries like New Zealand or the United Kingdom, where the government proactively campaigns to get those who don't quit off cigarettes. By doing that, I think public health can actually be improved much more rapidly than through any other measure that we have experienced until now. Well, first of all, there's an immediate gain in the fact that people have gone off cigarettes and adopted products that are a much better choice, like e-cigarettes or heated tobacco. In the UK, approximately a third of smokers, of people who smoke, have adopted those products. In Japan, 35% have adopted heated tobacco. If I take Vilnius, it's another city in Europe, we're talking about 45% who adopted IQOS. In Rome, 25%, and the list could go on. But more importantly, today, we actually start seeing emerging real-world evidence, for instance, from Japan and Korea, that indicates a correlation between the introduction of heated tobacco and hospitalizations for certain diseases related to smoking. Yes, it's early real-world evidence, but it's a clear indication of a direction that's much better than the previous one. I'm going to give you a very straightforward answer, because they're ideologically opposed to the industry, which I think is a mistake, because the focus should be on people who smoke and their health, not on hating an industry. That's not something a public health organization should do. I think they should learn from more progressive organizations such as the Food and Drug Administration in the US, the government of New Zealand, the government of the UK, all the other governments that have recently instead enacted pragmatic legislations that encourage the adoption of those products for people who don't quit, like Greece, like Italy, like Portugal. Ultimately, otherwise, they're going to miss an opportunity for exactly the objective they want to achieve, which is reducing the harm from smoking. We've always improved on our IQOS range, and since the very beginning we work to listen to our consumer and improve the pain points. Some of the things we've improved, in the previous version it was possible by mistake, accidentally, to break the blade that was inside. This doesn't happen with IQOS ILUMA because the heating system is different and works through induction, so there's actually no blade in the device. The second is exactly for this reason, it doesn't need cleaning. And I know that many consumers didn't like cleaning the products. Now, the good news is you don't need to do it anymore. The third is that the design has improved. It's much more customizable and it's much more tailored to what our consumers are looking to do. It's actually probably, I would say, I find it the best in the industry. And then there's another feature, which is previously you actually had to press a button to activate. Now you don't need to, because we created a very smart system through a magnet inside. Every time the stick is inserted into the device, it immediately turns it on and heats the stick. So those are some of the improvements, but look, what I can say is just people should try it and they'll see by themselves.